Part two of our Dominican Republic excursion landed us at the exquisite property of the Barcelo Bavaro Palace. We took a car service from Santo Domingo to Punta Cana, which was about a 2.5 hour ride going east. First, let me get you oriented with the accommodations. We had a one bedroom suite, had plenty of space. We had a full bar, queen size bed, double vanities in the bathroom, which was very spacious. But I have to tell you, the best element of this room and these accommodations are coming up right here. Check this out.
A beautiful, beautiful view right out of the room. Look at that. It's in the most remote part of the resort, which we requested. And just a spectacular ocean view. It is so beautiful. All right, I am at the juice bar getting my daily smoothie. Pineapples, got some bananas thrown in on mine. There's some other options, cucumbers, spinach, watermelon, but I got papaya as well. This has been my go-to smoothie almost every day here on the resort. In the DR, papaya, banana, and piña, pineapple. Look at this. Down three so far, I got two more to go.
One of our most enjoyable excursions was heading out to Scape Park, which is about 35 minutes away from the resort.
We're at Scape Park, beautiful little park. We just finished the zip line. Pretty cool. We did about 7 or 8 zip lines. There's a few more that you can do. You can do a hammock, you can do the Superman style. Fun.
Besides the zip lines, the park had many other elements that were very enjoyable. There was an open-air zoo, and there was these cenotes, very similar to what you see in Playa del Carmen, where you walk into a cave and you get to the bottom of it, and it's these beautiful pools of water that you can swim and enjoy. Another element were these aerial obstacle courses where you had to navigate high above ground, these little tight spaces, and move and maneuver between obstacles. The family loved it, not so much to my liking. I was real cool on it, but they had a great time. The park had several of these huge watering holes. This one is at the mouth of a cave out in the open, but just again, really nice way to kind of cool off during a very hot day. All the attractions and eco trails sit on about 250 acres of land.
So we are in the Dominican Republic near Punta Cana. And just a good example, we are in a forest. We're at the Scape Park. But one of the things I want to highlight is how the forest has a natural mulch layer. Look at that, you just dig through and it's just the roots and the system, the leaves, the insects, look at the root layer. It's right there, covered up by the mulch layer. This is what happens actually in nature that we want to duplicate in our backyard orchards.
When you come to the park, make sure you bring walking shoes. They do have lockers, so it makes it very convenient to have a change of clothes and a place to lock it up. All in all, I recommend this place. Big thumbs up. Made it back to the resort to enjoy a teppanyaki prepared dinner. Now take a look at this. This was our dessert. Any idea what this is? I'll give you a hint. It is fruit. Any guesses?
Lychee and caramel sauce. What a unique combination.
Tasty food with tight chef skills was the proper way to end our day. For the next phase of our Dominican Republic tour, we chose to do a four-hour ATV adventure. There are many companies to choose from. We chose one that was highly rated and had three stops as part of the tour. After they got us acclimated to the vehicle and safety measures, we were off to our first stop.
You have the coffee beans and the cacao. Coffee beans and cacao, both into the same process. You're gonna put them the sun dry for 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, the coffee changes the color. The coffee becomes like me, black, okay? Now we're gonna put the...
We got an education and samples of chocolate and coffee. And by the way, the tea made from cacao leaves was excellent. We made a purchase and brought some home. I love getting that education and understanding about how things are made. And by the way, everywhere we look, more mango trees. After the plantation tour, we jumped back into our ATVs and we were off to the next location. And the next stop was a water cave. And as we arrived at the next location, there were a lot of vendors selling souvenir items as well as fruit. And walking to the natural swimming pools, it was a little bit more unstructured than, say at Scape Park. Folks would approach you from all directions, selling you either equipment or trying to get you to buy souvenirs, stuff like that. And once you make it all the way down, there's this beautiful cenote, beautiful, gorgeous water. We didn't get in because we did it at Scape Park, but the people that did had a really good time. And once again, we headed out to the next destination, which was the beautiful Macau Beach. It was a really nice beach, very secluded, pretty private. We had the beach mostly to ourselves. You could unwind, stretch out, and just relax and enjoy it. A lady approached us. She was selling mangoes and a fruit I didn't recognize, but I always like to support, the local workers and the people trying to, make a living, and we bought some of the fruit. The inside was fleshy with a pit like a lychee and the taste a cross between a lychee and a citrus. I ordered one of the best pina coladas I've ever had, refreshing. It was made fresh inside of an actual pineapple. And believe it or not, I had one of the best seasoned fish I had on the entire trip that was prepared nearby. So as we left the beach, took one more look back at this gorgeous beach we spent an hour on. And I look up and I see the exact fruit I just bought. They appear to be pretty plentiful. And that concluded our wonderful day enjoying the ATV excursion. The next day we ventured out to find local produce sold at a farmer's market.
Want to get some mangoes? Is there anything you want?
After striking out with a couple dead ends and some wild goose chases in an Uber, we finally located a area that was selling locally sourced fruit. And for me, it's just another opportunity to get immersed in the culture, to kind of see how they go about some of their daily lives, and see the varieties of fruit that they have. Some I'm familiar with, some I'm not. And it's just an educational process and an experience that was great to participate in. Later that evening, we ventured out for grown folks' night at Coco Bongo. We got there around 10 o'clock in the evening. The night starts off pretty tame. There's not a lot of crowds that early on. I bought VIP seats, which was great. It gave us designated seats. It gave us access to the bar. And all I can tell you about Coco Bongo is it's just a place you have to see to comprehend. Take a look.
Yeah. on second thoughts, let's not go to Camelot. It is a silly place.
Right.
Yeah, Coco Bongo is this silly, frantic, energetic, visual place. Certainly a spectacle, that's for sure. We enjoyed it. We left about 1:30 or 2 in the morning. You walk out, the place is packed. There's a bunch of eateries and bars that are lined up that you can enjoy and partake in till, I guess, the sun comes up. The next day was all about beach time. And as I mentioned previously, we were located right in front of the ocean. So we were able to walk out into the ocean and just get into the water, appreciate nature. The water was super warm. It was like a jacuzzi. Very soothing, very relaxing, hanging out, seeing some of the animals, the stingrays, the sea turtles, etc. It was really good. And so it's just a wonderful way to kind of wind down from a busy trip with lots of excursions and just take a moment to enjoy nature.
All right, we have here some of the fruits that we've acquired since being on this trip in the Dominican Republic. We've got some mangoes, we got some bananas, beautiful avocado, some fruit that I've yet to identify, but it's kind of like a lychee. A little fleshy insides with a huge seed in the middle. And then some of the typical fruits that we're getting on the resort. Papayas, watermelon, bananas, pineapples.
The next day, we woke up to very strong winds and rain as Hurricane Beryl was just south of us on the day we were leaving to fly home.
So the weather's really changed very quickly. We've had good weather this entire time on this trip, but Hurricane Beryl is just to the south of us, probably directionally due south at the moment, the eye of the hurricane. And we, over the last few minutes, it's about 11 o'clock on Tuesday. The last few minutes, the rain has really picked up. The winds picked up this morning, but now it's joined by pretty heavy rain. Our flight's at 3. We're hoping this blows over before we take off. But wow, it's really picking up.
Couple of hours later, the storm passed, the clouds cleared up, and we were set to fly home. It was such a rewarding trip to learn so much about the Dominican Republic, the people, the culture, the fruit, things to do. I hope you enjoyed viewing our DR excursion. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.